Hey you, yeah you, hop on aboard for Quota Place Express. Welcome to the Lusail Shooting Complex here in Doha, and to help explain how the ISSF Final Olympic Qualification Championship is going to work is competition manager Jasim. Jasim, how are you doing?
Pretty good, thank you for asking, and welcome back.
Yeah, good to be back in Doha as always. So, we have eight Paris 2024 Olympic Games quota places up for grabs. How will they be distributed?
Yes, it's going to be two per event. So two for skeet men and two for skeet women, two for trap men, two for trap women.
Obviously, very important quota places for many athletes. It's their last chance to secure them. How many athletes are here and also how many nations?
Actually, there is 433 athletes out of 83 nations, which is, I think, a record for the ISSF. It caused a little bit of a schedule change. As you see, this competition is a three-day competition, not the normal two-day competition. Especially that in this, like, this region, the sun sets pretty early, not like some other places. So it's going good, I guess. The players liked it. It's more relaxed. It's more comfortable. And we wish all the best, you know. And I think it's not the... It is the last competition to win the quotas, but there will be more quotas distributed by the ISSF after, according to rankings and other points.
Yeah, it's one of those final chances. So there's high stakes here in Doha, it's fair to say. But also, there are athletes here who have come already securing quotas. What kind of reasons have they given for that?
Yes, like for the trap men now, we have at least, I think, eight athletes who already qualified. I think they're using that chance to... It's like a camp for them. They want to play against other, like, world-class players. They want to play in a world-class complex. They're using it, obviously, as training for the Olympics. And we are welcoming all of them, you know, in our shooting complex. If they can win, they can win. But the quota goes a step down if one of them took the lead.
And finally, you have hosted many events here already. You talked about some of the challenges unique to the country, time of year, with sunset, also with this competition, the schedule. Focusing on this competition, what kind of unique challenges has it thrown up, as well as that schedule issue?
Yeah, as usual, every competition we had, always the focus point was the player and the player, you know, atmosphere and how they feel being here. So our first challenge was, we know it's in April, it's the first competition that we hosted in April. Usually we do February, March, where the weather is still nice. In April, the sun is kind of hot, it's not as humid. So we had to make sure that every facility is air conditioned, that the players got all the comfortable measures to be able to adjust to the weather. And as I told you, the number is bigger than what we expected. At the end, you know, the Qatar Shooting and Archery Federation always focuses on the atmosphere of the players. They are the focus and they are the point of every competition. If they are satisfied, we are satisfied.
Well, Jasim, thank you for talking to me and good luck with the competition.
Thank you and hope to see you again.
Yeah.
So tomorrow, Tuesday, it all gets started with the trap women's final, followed by the men, and you can watch all of the action live from 3 p.m. local time on Facebook and YouTube. See you there.